card, I'm in charge of the starship. An artist in the jargon of Martians, charging off in the darkness where no man's come before in the way.
My guy Robert Garcia, my trainer, he's working on dissecting his style, but with me, it's more of what he presents in front of me is what advantage I can take and go from there and set up a plan and a trap for him. That's usually the type of fighter that I am. I'm strategic in that ring, so whatever he gives me in that first round, if we can end it as early as the first round or as late as the 12th round, we're always ready for anything.
Do you feel pressure to have to, you know, make a big statement and have to look really good because it is your first fight on the East Coast?
Well, it's just more of just defeating Narvaez. I mean, we want to look spectacular because, you know, one thing that when I started to be where I'm at is because I accepted that boxing, as much as it's a sport, as much as it's an art for me, but it's also an entertainment. You know, you gotta entertain the people, and that's one thing that I have in my head is that, you know, I gotta look spectacular. You know, I've did it with Sudarenko, I did it with Montiel. I just wanna keep that streak going so that there's no more of me than that.
In your two big fights, Darcini and Montiel, you still both knockouts with counter left hooks. Is that your punch? Is that something that would opportunistic? Or is that something that you do, that you've been practicing on, that you've been training?
Well, I trained that hook for a long time. I mean, we've known to train that hook for Darcini because he was open with that, as well as Montiel. You know, that's what we planned out. I mean, you can ask all my guys in the corner. I planned everything that I was into that ring before. I told everyone in the second round I was gonna knock him out because I have him here. I got him here. I got him here. You know, I kind of planned it out for the guys and I explained it exactly as well how it happened or close to it. I mean, Robert can tell you everything how I explained it and how the fight was gonna end. But I mean, for this fight, we just mainly focus on being in top shape. You know, I think that just being off the ring for a while, I think that we needed to get in the best possible shape, and that's what the focus for this fight is, to be in the best possible shape.
Do you see similar opportunities against Narvaez?
Well, Narvaez is he's a tricky fighter. He's a tricky fighter, he's a veteran. And the thing is, you know, if Montiel was open with that right, I would have taken him out with the right, you know. That was our first thing with Montiel, was to counter him with the right, but he was more difficult to do it, so we focused it on the left side. But with Narvaez, if he gives me the opportunity with the left hook or even with the straight, we'll take him out with it. I mean, the thing about me is that if you make a mistake in front of me, I'll make you pay for it. And that's the same thing that goes with Narvaez. If I make a mistake, I try to just not make mistakes in there. I mean, it's hard, but at least minor mistakes is fine, but not in a big mistake where he can counter me and you know, and take advantage of the situation.
What do you see in his style that maybe you could take advantage of just from watching tape and watching his
Well, I didn't really watch his tape, you know. One thing that I looked at is the way he stands, and I believe that I can take a lot of advantage of the way he stands. But then again, it's also tricky, you know. You never really know. I mean, the guy has been fighting for forever. The guy's 36 years old, and he's still undefeated, and that's the biggest thing. I mean, he's a legend in Argentina. You know, he's defended his title more than, I think, 12 times. Was it 12 times? So you know what credibility this guy has inside that ring, and that's one thing that we don't want to overlook. Just because he's shorter than I am, being short is also a lot trickier than the guys who's right in front of me or the same height, you know. So that's one thing that we never want to look past, is his ability to know how to change the weather.
How does he stand? Is he more flat-footed or just is he squared up more?
He's pretty square up, you know. It's his back foot that I look at, his front foot that I look at where it's pointing, and because where it is, it's wherever his back foot is pointing is where I can be on the opposite side or directly in front of where I can take advantage of. But that would rely mostly on my speed, you know, and whatever he has. I mean, like I said, I have the height advantage, the speed advantage, and the power advantage, but you know, sometimes it only takes one skill to defeat another, you know. Like with me, I believe that timing can defeat speed any time. You know, I believe power can can be nullified by speed. So there's just goes around in that circle, and I try to get my talent and prepare myself in the balance of power, speed, and stamina, so that I don't have to worry about anything, you know. But whatever he gives at me, I'm ready for it.
It was a big fight on Saturday with Hopkins and Dawson, and that fight, you know, ended kind of ugly, where, you know, Dawson threw Hopkins to the floor. I mean, you know, after what happened there in that big fight, do you feel like maybe you want to give the fans a good performance just because of what they did again?
Well, they're always the thing that I can, you know, I'm always. I feel blessed with the situation that I have, the life that I have, and I'm always thankful for my fans for being there, supporting me, and praying for me. And the least that I can do is perform. You know, there's no doubt in my mind that I'm ready, and I'm gonna try to perform the best possible way. But it takes two to tango. You know, so we need a participation from Narvaez, but I think that he is willing because he represents his country of Argentina, and he is a legend of Argentina. But he's facing somebody in a different world right now, and you know, that's what we're gonna try to give him is the best of what he has, and I guess the best of what I have.
Can you talk about your family support and how important that is to you?
It's great important for me to have my family, my wife, and her family, and then just everyone, the supporter, my whole fan base. I mean, it's all a blessing to me, and that's why I fight the way I fight, and that's why I train the way I train, because I'm thankful for every situation, for every time that they take pictures of me, that I give autographs to them. I'm blessed with the life that I have because I never thought that I'd be here.
Does your wife handle a lot of stuff that you don't need to handle or want to handle?
Well, take it this morning, you know, it was her who called everybody that needed to be called for interviews. You know, it was her who called, and she does a lot more than just being a wife. You know, she manages a lot of my schedule. She manages a lot of everything that goes on. I mean, I think that she's my leg. She's making me walk right now, and that's the kind of support that I have with my wife, and that's really important for me. Glad because she understands what I do, and there's that 100% support, and that no matter what, she will always believe in me. I think going in that ring with that mentality just makes a man more a man.
What about you, your fans? You seem like you really love the actual process of fighting. Why do you love fighting?
You know what? A couple years ago, after I beat 13 in a few fights, my wife asked me, why do you box? I couldn't answer her. You know, it was something that I didn't have. I did it for everybody else. I did it for my father. I did it for anything that wasn't me. You know, and when I started to realize that, I realized that I love the sport of boxing. I love fighting because, you know, God has given me this talent, and I've spent all my life in it. And why not look back and you know, and look around and just enjoy the moment? And that's what I'm doing right now, is I'm enjoying the moment, and hopefully I can help a lot of people out there. And that's why we're working with the People Breast Foundation for the breast cancer awareness for this month. And whatever we can help, I mean, you know, that's one thing that I do now with boxing, is I'll use it to spread awareness, I'll use it to increase awareness of what's going on around the world, and what needs to be healthy, and how to be healthy, and stuff like that, and whatever help that I can to bring forth the blessings that I have in boxing. You know, now when people ask me why do I box, you know, I'll say that, you know, I box because I enjoy the sport, I love the sport, and mainly, you know, at the end of it all, I hope I can inspire other people out there, other kids out there, the way that I was inspired to do the best that I can.
Do you expect a lot of fans from your country?
I believe that there'll be a lot of fans who's coming in. I mean, around the area, from Jersey City, from around this area, New York, there's been a lot of Filipino communities is reaching out. There's a lot of them has been going into my training and just giving me a lot of support, and I'm really thankful for just the whole support that they have given me and prayers. You know, it's amazing. I mean, the other day or yesterday, I went and talked to the kids at a New Jersey school, and I talked with a lot of Filipino kids about just inspiration and about just doing their best, about just becoming who they want to be, and how they can achieve it, you know, by doing their best, you know, and it was great to be in front of the kids and in front of the people, Filipino people, to tell why I am and why I'm here for.
Nonito, after this one, I know you don't like to look ahead. I'll say next, I know you've told me many times,
Well, there is, you know, I came to watch the fight with Narvaez, Marquez, and Nishioka. There is that one guy, Nishioka, that I want to face, but of course, Arce is a great name. You know, out of all those two, out of all the division title holder, I would go for those two. I think those two are incredible fighters. I have great respect for them, and especially Arce, he's ready to go to war. You know, and I'm ready to go to war, but we don't want to look fast and forth in our lives.
You told me sometime ago, if you hope to go all the way up to junior lightweight.
Well, that depends, you know. 122, how I fare with 122, then I'll move up to featherweight. If I can handle the featherweight guys like Gamboa and Warma, you know, I would move up to lightweight and see how I go from there. But it's a step-by-step process. Right now, what I'm thinking about is just taking our bias and going up to 22 and see how I fare from there, and just step by step. You know, that's the glory of time. And you can do it step by step for me, and just enjoy every moment of it.
You have no trouble making weight now.
Well, I thought that I would be making a lot of trouble making this weight. You know, because I started like 2 months and a half ago at 145. You know, but that was being away from the gym for about 6 months. So it was a struggle. There was a mental struggle where, man, I don't think I can make it, man. I don't think I can make it. But I've always been true to my word that I will never, ever fail to make weight. You know, if I say I'll make 112, I'll make 112. When I say I'll make 115, I'll make 115. When I say I'll make 118, I will make 118.
You've always been mentioned like in the same breath with Pacquiao because you're also known. You know, do you look up to Manny in terms of what he's done?
Manny has been part of why I'm here. You know, he has inspired me because by showing that, you know, there is no impossibility of what a man can do as long as they put their heart and be pure of what they desire inside that ring, and that is winning. You know, I believe that, you know, Manny has been a big part of my success now because of the fact that, you know, I was inspired by him. I mean, I was inspired by a lot of people along the way, you know, by my great friend Andre Ward, you know, Bruce Lee. I mean, you name all the guys that a kid can be inspired on. But, you know, Manny was one of the inspiration because he's Filipino. And at the moment, back in 2000, I would try and seek managers, and they would say, I'm sorry, kid, you're not Mexican, you know, or I'm sorry, kid, you're not Latino. I'm sorry, kid, you don't speak Spanish. You know, and he's always been that way. Manny has opened that door for me and given me that opportunity, so I'm always going to be thankful.
Are you guys friends?
Oh yeah, we're friends. I mean, I've known him since 2000, 2001. We used to karaoke a lot. That boy can karaoke all day. We love that though, but you know, we would have a few drinks here and there, but you know, the life was really simple back then, and it was incredible just to see him the way he was, you know, and the way he is, the way he's going to be, you know, so I always support Manny, and he's always be a friend. You know, when I see him, we always have lunch and stuff like that. So there's always that mutual respect for each other.
Do you aspire to, like, you know, to reach that kind of success that Manny's gotten? We're not just in boxing, but also outside of boxing, kind of a crossover.
Well, I aspire to be the best what I can be. You know, that's one thing that I've learned in boxing is I want to see. That's why I always seek to challenge the best out there, because I want to see who can beat me. I want to see how far I can get. I want to see what weight I can get. You know, that's the glory of it, is that the more you try, you know, the more you'll see how far you'll get. The more your stars shine brighter, you know, when you try. You know, when you try and do it, you just tend to see more of the light, you know. And at the end of it all, you know, I hope I'll see that light closer than anything. But just doing my best is all that I really want to do, you know, and see how far it can get. I mean, it can be big like Manny, or it could be just right now, you know, but doing my best and getting out of that ring, not saying what if, shoulda, woulda, coulda, you know, but at least be proud of what I've done. So that's pretty much the things that I look into boxing, is just doing my best and see how far I can go.
When